Katrina's Princesscapades. Now, you might be noticing that I have a bit of a funny accent today. And there's a reason for that. Tomorrow is my very last day as a princess before I leave for my program. And I bet you can guess which princess that is.
That's right, Merida.
Now, I thought for maybe this week's video, I'd show you the process of getting ready to become a princess. And show you a little bit of what it takes to be one. It's not as easy as what you might think, right? Now, before I become a character, I need to do a lot of research. So, for one thing today, I watched the movie Brave, of course, to study the character of Merida. And study her mannerisms and the way she talks. So Merida is a very specific character. She has a funny way of walking and talking and all sorts of things. She's quite the character, unlike maybe someone who's like Belle. Or someone more like Anna. Hi there! Or even someone more like Snow White. Do you like gooseberry pie just as much as I do? When you meet your Snow White. So obviously all these characters have very distinct qualities, but Merida is special. She has even more distinctive things about her, of course, her crazy hair and her dress. Today I'm just going to show you a little bit of what it takes for me to get into character. So obviously I watched the movie and I did some research there. And another thing you have to do is makeup so that your face looks fully like her. Now, I already have kind of Merida's round face, so that's what I got going for me here. But she has quite more fair details on her face than I do. So I'm going to have to be doing quite a bit of makeup to make myself a lot more Scottish. So I'm just going to do a little makeup trial for you here, and then tomorrow maybe I'll video a little bit of myself in character and you'll see what it looks like all together.
So here we go!
First off, getting your hair out. CC cream, mine's from Cover Girl. Then I apply it on a sponge. Face. Ooh. Oh, right then. Next. Actually, now Merida is a very, very neutral toned face, so you don't want to wear a lot of eyeshadow. So I'm gonna take my NYC individual eyes. Individual eyes. And I'm gonna take. There's the primer based here. Just prime my eyes here and get it ready for putting on whatever I'm putting on here. Mm-hmm. Just rub it around. And take my brush. And take the lightest color. Take this champagne color here.
your blush. So I have the red one, enchantment. It's hard to read, it's all messed up here. But it's a cream blush that I like to use in order to almost any princess. Just mix it all in. Raise your finger and apply it to her cheeks. And for Merida, even lower, because she has a big throat. Now, here's normally where I would put on my fake eyelashes. So I've got these ones. This is the ones that I like to wear, but I'm not going to wear them today because I don't want to waste any uses of them. But, so I have e.l.f. brand here. I just got them from the dollar store, and they work perfectly fine. And then I bought Revlon Precision Lashes, and it works really well, actually. It's like you've got like a cute brush to brush it on. It works really nicely for the eyelashes. I'm not going to wear them too. After you've got your eyelashes on, you put on your mascara. I have Scandalize Show On from the Merida. And I just go some very nicely shaped eyebrows. Where's our coldest hide secrets? And mountains are fierce and bold. Deep waters hold reflections of times lost long ago. As I hear their every story, take hold of my own dream. Be as strong as the seas are stormy. I'm proud as an eagle's wing. Kind of make little circles on my face. It makes it kind of lighter than using just this love it is a using like an eyebrow pencil that would just make it look like you have like a disease or something. So using a Q-tip like this kind of makes it more soft. Softer edges, just a little bit more natural. I try to speak to you every day. So there's some freckles there. Now normally I would have a setting spray that's just for your face right now. Lipstick. She has like kind of a burnt orangish red color. So I don't have that color, so I'm trying to make it out of some color. I'm going to take this darker red I have in this pink here and mix it a little bit. Mix it with that color, so with a little bit of this. I might have to try something else. How did we let it come?
works for now. Tomorrow, on the actual day I do it, I'll have the color I need at my work. They have a bunch of different colors to use, so I'll have the lipstick that I need. But for now, this is what we'll use. Alright, so this is kind of what my face will look like going into wearing the wig, plus giving lipstick and plus eyelashes. So just imagine a big curly wig, and I guess we'll see when I shave.
Why, hello there! Isn't it a great day today? It'll be so much fun out there today! Well, that was my day. I had a wonderful time today, and there's the castle behind me. And I guess have a wonderful day for you too. Farewell.
So that's kind of what it's like to be a princess, a party princess, or at least the process of getting into it. I can't really film while I'm working, so that's about as much as you can see, unless you came and actually visited me, I guess. But that's not gonna happen because it's my last shift. Like, subscribe, all that jazz, and maybe you could see more of another day. And hopefully in the future I'll get to be a princess again and maybe I can show a little bit more, but this is it until I leave for Florida, so I guess that's it. And I am 13 days till I fly! Yay! Thanks for watching, everyone! Have a wonderful day!